everywhere Margaret looked in life, she had been surrounded by love. But in segregated North Carolina in the late 1920s, Margaret Hicks Morris saw hate after her family beat up a white salesman who had groped and hit her mother.
Three Ku Klux men standing over us. It was the most horrible thing that any child would want to see.
Beverly, New Jersey would become the lasting home of the Hicks clan, and Margaret saw her first real baseball diamond, much nicer than the one back in North Carolina.
A bat house was the first base, and then we go around the chicken coop, that was the second base. Around the pig pen was the third base. There's still the slide marks on it.
It was the unstoppable softball team she and her sisters founded, the Beverly Amazons, that would start to undo the discrimination she met on the first day of school.
When I got in there, they turned around, they pushed me out, said, "You can't come in here because this is only for white people."
But from the other side of the tracks, wealthy white families started coming to the Amazons' game, where they saw them defeat all comers, even men disguised as women.
We would fall, we would slide, we would crawl anywhere to get the ball. And because our motto was, nobody's going to get into runs if possible.
She went on to march with Dr. King, become a licensed minister, and live to see the nation's first black president.
I'm so proud. I say now, just think that I had a little bit of part in that.
And now, 2 months shy of her 90th birthday, Margaret is content to enjoy her family and her mention in history books. But it is what Margaret and her team did on that field in Beverly that tops them all.
We brought the whole town together as one.
In Beverly, New Jersey, I'm Doug Scheimel, NBC 10 News.